From cats and dogs to chickens and even snakes, all can be considered emotional support animals with almost no proof.
Florida lawmakers want to crack down on fakers, though. NBC2 chief political reporter Dave Elias shows us how.
Yeah, aside from demanding proof that your animal is a support animal, it also forbids landlords from charging you more to keep your animal. It also holds the pet owner liable for any damage that the animal could do to rented property.
You ready to go for a field trip, bud?
Shania Bergman is a senior at FGCU. Coda is her emotional support animal.
He is vital to every day. I mean, without him, I don't think I would be able to get through every day.
She lives here on campus and needed her doctor to prove Coda was an emotional support animal.
The process of getting him here was a very, very difficult one, but once he's been here, he's been greatly accepted by my roommates.
We have seen an increase in students, clients, patients, overall, and people seeking these letters for an emotional support animal.
FGCU does not, though, allow emotional support animals in classrooms or common areas.
Emotional support animals sometimes can be animals that other people are afraid of. When that happens, then we are not emotionally supporting people who have fears.
Someone cannot just claim, this is my support animal, and be able to go to get away with that.
State Representative Anna Eskimani supporting House Bill 209 that requires proof from a doctor.
There really does have to be some sort of verified medical proof.
A landlord could demand it before renting a property and hold the pet owner responsible for damages.
Glenn, you're famous.
It also penalizes pet owners who fraudulently pay for letters from doctors online.
If you're struggling to the point where you need an emotional support animal, then you need therapy or some kind of ongoing treatment.
Now, lawmakers for years say people have been misusing pets as emotional support animals in order to keep them in their rental property and even take them on plane trips. Some online doctors will provide a letter for as little as just $50, a practice the bill would like to stop. Live in the studio, Dave Elias, NBC2.